seeing those. Starting the second quarter, second down and 7 for Marshall, trailing 13-0. And second and 7 from their own 5. Cato to pass from his own end zone, completes to Tommy Schuler. And Schuler brings it up the 11. A completion of 6 yards. Look at those first quarter stats. And check out the balance of West Virginia. You expect to see more passing yards, but they're having success both ways.
They're not afraid to run it. And if it's working, they'll generally go away from it.
Third and 1. Can Marshall convert on third down? The handoff to Van. Van cuts it back, and he will get the first down. A 4-yard run on third and 1 by Trayvon Van.
Trayvon Van here just using his quickness there just to make a cut and get upfield.
Just the third first down of the game so far for Marshall. Play action. Cato completes the pass to Eric Fronapple, his tight end. And Fronapple up to the 18. A pickup of 3 sets up second and 7.
Sensing a little bit of mixing it up here, giving it to the running back, getting spread empties with no backs, getting into back formation, throwing it to your tight end. Maybe they're settling down a little bit.
Handoff up the middle. Again, it's Trayvon Van. Gets tripped up by Terrence Garvin. Second tackle of the game for Garvin.
Trayvon Van kind of getting a little bit winded there, slow to get up.
Third and 3 coming up here for Marshall. Empty backfield. Cato in the shotgun. Quarterback draw up the middle, and Cato has the first down. Very nice call there for Marshall. And now let's go back to the injury with Garrett Scott.
Look at the right tackle, Jarrett Scott. Comes down, and then a West Virginia player just comes in late trying to make a tackle and runs right into that left knee.
First and 10 now for Marshall. High snap, hand off to Stuart Butler. Butler, the redshirt freshman from Lakeland, Florida, picks up 3 yards.
Trying to get the running game established here with the draw, handoff. Try to feel a little bit more comfortable. Get that offensive line back when you've got starter getting injured, player coming in to replace him. Try to make this offensive line feel comfortable.
Second down and 7. Trayvon Van in the backfield. Play action. Cato has some time, looking deep down the field to Dobson, and he overthrows him.
He had him beat, had the secondary beat. Roderick Jenkins there. Just needs to put a little bit more air on that ball and let Dobson run under it. He would have had a touchdown.
He could have walked into the end zone. Aaron Dobson, one of the best wide receivers in the country, carrying on the legacy. They say he could be the best wide receiver here at Marshall since, yeah, you know who, Randy Moss.
You may not have that many opportunities for a big play.
Third and 7. Cato rolling out to his right. Pressure. Throws on the run, and the pass is complete to Eric Fronapple, his tight end, who picks up the first down up to the 40-yard line, a completion of 24 yards.
Really like what Cato did here, keeping that play alive, you know, getting on the outside, using his feet, using his speed. He's worked out in the offseason. He's gotten stronger, made an accurate throw.
Just a sophomore is Rakeem Cato. Started the opening game last year here in Morgantown. Movement out front, the flags come flying. And let's see who moved first.
Offside. Defense, number 95. Contact in the neutral zone. 5-yard penalty, first down.
Christian Brown called for the penalty.
Eric Fronapple, a big target for Cato to hit. Just goes up, reaches up for that ball, makes a big play.
10th play of the drive. The handoff to Van, who cuts it back, has some running room. A nice fake as he gets tripped up at the 19-yard line by the freshman Carl Joseph. A 16-yard run for Trayvon Van.
Good opening block here by Josh Lovell, making that one little quick move, getting in the open field.
First red zone opportunity here for Marshall. Cato again forced out of the pocket, throws it up as he gets hit hard. The pressure applied by Will Clark. It'll be second down and 10 here for Marshall.
Looking for his tight end, C.J. Crawford. It's a little bit out of the reach. And a little bit of pressure that made him throw an inaccurate pass.
Second and 10. You can see that Big 12 Conference logo there on the field. That's right, West Virginia. One of two new members in the Big 12 this year. Kato's throw to the sideline is complete to Dobson. And Dobson gets wrapped up by Broderick Jenkins, who now has four tackles in the game, a 12-yard pickup, and a first down here for Marshall. First and goal coming up from the 7-yard line for the Thundering Herd.
Rakeem Kato trying to get into a little bit of a rhythm here.
Remy Watson is now in at tailback. The handoff is to Watson, who's got good speed, stays on his feet, falls forward. And Watson will pick up 3 yards, the tackle by Isaiah Bruce. Now think about this. If you remember correctly, as we take a look at this run here by Watson, this drive by Marshall started all the way back near their own goal line.
What a confidence builder.
Then the run, then to the end zone, touchdown. Trayvon Van gets Marshall on the board.
Trayvon Van showing some speed and agility. Saw the opening, got right in the end zone.
On for the extra point is Justin Haig. The kick is good. It is now a 13-7 game. A 98-yard drive. The big play was the third down conversion to Eric Fronapple. And then another youngster, Trayvon Van, the sophomore, gets into the end zone. 13-7 West Virginia. Justin Haig to kick off. Taven Austin and Stephen Bailey are back deep. A short kick. Taken at the 16-yard line. Ryan Clark on the return. A 16-yard return there for Clark. This West Virginia defense, they could not stop Marshall at last drive. For more on them, let's go back down to Darius Walker.
Yeah, guys, if you were watching West Virginia on defense, you'll notice that all the players are looking to the sideline trying to get the play. It's causing a bit of a problem because they're not getting lined up. So that last series, Marshall definitely took advantage of that. Back up to you guys.
All right, thanks, Darius. Justin Kutcher, Eric Crouch, Darius Walker here for this first game of the season here on Fox. 13-7, West Virginia leading Marshall. On first down, the pass complete to Taven Austin. And Austin tried to cut it back. Got tackled by DJ Hunter, a pickup of just one.
I think there's a sense of urgency right now for this offense to get going and come down the field and score on this drive. They want to make sure that they don't necessarily take all the momentum away from what they had in the first quarter.
On second and 9, Smith, a lot of time over the middle, completes the pass to J.D. Woods. And Woods picks up the first down, a pickup of 12. Well, this college football season, Fox Sports is proud to partner with the Prostate Cancer Foundation, the world's largest supporter of prostate cancer research. 1 in 6 American men will be diagnosed with prostate cancer in their lifetime. To learn more, please visit www.pcf.org/Fox Sports. First and 10 on the 44-yard line for West Virginia. Smith. Complete once again to Woods. And Woods again has the first down, a pickup of 14. Well, this offensive line is certainly giving Geno Smith time to throw.
Yeah, they are. They're actually doing an awesome job of blocking and picking up their pass protections. You can see that Marshall's trying to do a few different things, but they're just taking what they're giving them right now.
Geno Smith on first and 10, taking his time. Handoff. Good run by Andrew Bowie. And Bowie brings it up across the 25, up the 24-yard line. An 18-yard run by the sophomore.
You certainly tell the running game, the offensive line, nice cut block. Nice cutback. And a way to pick up the yards downfield. Geno Smith in the shotgun with Andrew Bowie in the backfield with him. Smith, delayed draw to Bowie. Bowie up the middle. Has a blocker towards the corner. Touchdown. ...24-yard touchdown run by Andrew Bowie. What you saw there is the defense was kind of playing around with Geno Smith. They had their linebackers up in the line, and at the last minute they backed off, which gave him the space after the handoff for him to have a lot of room to run.
Tyler Bittencourt on for the extra point. Response by West Virginia after Marshall with a 98-yard drive for a touchdown. The answer, Andrew Bowie. Delayed draw. Takes it in from 24 yards out. 19-17 West Virginia. All right, thanks so much, Patrick. That studio looks awesome. Andrew Bowie, a 24-yard touchdown run. Caps off that five-play, 68-yard drive for West Virginia. And it's now a 20-7 lead for West Virginia. Corey Smith will kick off. Andre Snipes Booker is back deep. And Snipes Booker, he will take the knee and start at the 25. 4 yards. So gaining some confidence on the last one. Will it carry over to this one? On first down. Play action. Going deep down the middle to his man. Dobson completes the pass. And he gets dragged down at the 31-yard line. No, the pitch eight down now at the 35-yard line. Broderick Jenkins there on the stop.
What a great play action. He kind of crouched down a little bit, got low after the fake, and then made that great, beautiful pass over the top of the defenseman.
First and 10. Handoff to Trayvon Van. Van dancing. There is a flag on the play, though. Doug Rigg there on the tackle, a pickup of two, but let's see what the flag is for. Mike Diffie is our referee for today's game.
There's no foul on the play. Second down.
Well, that makes it easy.
Let's line up and run another play.
Means we're going to have second down and 8 here for Marshall. With 9 minutes to go here in the first half. Cato dropping back. Tommy Schuler. Little bubble screen, and Schuler gets back the line of scrimmage. Kyle Rose with his first tackle of the game.
J.B. Langman, too, with Bogman, making a great job of coming up and stopping that from being a really big play.
Third and 8 coming up here for Marshall. They need to get to the 25-yard line. Hakeem Cato changing the play. The handoff to Van up the middle. Got the first down. Ran into his own teammate, but picks up 10. Another big run by Trayvon Van. And now Marshall not wasting any time. Again, it's to Van, who kind of stumbled out of the backfield. And it looks like they're going to mark him down behind the line of scrimmage, a loss of 1. You can see Marshall trying to get in that hurry up, try to catch that West Virginia defense off.
That's right, they're trying something a little bit different here. Change the tempo of the game.
Cato, A strong throw complete to Schuler. A 6-yard completion up to the 18-yard line.
Good job of Cato by placing that ball. He saw that there was some coverage outside that if you would have kept leading him outside, could have been a big hit on his receiver.
Third and 5 coming up here for Marshall. Cato passes, tips, and it's incomplete. Intended for Tommy Schuler. Broderick Jenkins there on the coverage.
Broderick Jenkins really coming through and making a big play right here when they need it.
Justin Haig will come on for a 35-yard field goal attempt to try to make this a 10-point game. Haig from 35. And that is good. Haig to kick off. Bailey is back deep. And Bailey takes this one at the goal line, fumbles it, able to pick it up. Stedman Bailey is tackled at the 12-yard line. Geno Smith got off to a great start for this West Virginia team, doing pretty much what we expected to see from him in this game.
Yeah, he really has. He's made accurate throws. He's made great decisions. Good long, deep balls that he's worked on over the summer. Still a lot of work to be done today.
Good numbers, just 2 incompletions in his 15 pass attempts. Set records last year for West Virginia in yards, pass attempts, and completions. Broke all the records set by Mark Bulger. On first down, Smith with a reverse to Tavon Austin. Austin has that blazing speed, gets to the outside. Tavon Austin with a foot race. Down the sideline, tries to cut it back, and he gets wrestled down around the 10-yard line.
Really just using his speed right there. You saw it was blazing.
Keith Baxter able to chase him down after a 70-yard run by Tavon Austin. The Mountaineers not wasting any time getting to the line. First and 10 from the 13. Smith completes the pass to Austin, and he gets tackled at the 6. Evan McKelvey and Okochukwu Okoroa, who, by the way, may be having the best name in college football, they're combined for the tackle. Again, it's to Austin. Apparently, he's not tired because he goes in for the touchdown.
Well, it sure didn't take long. Tavon Austin, just a quick pass. They just picked up their tempo right here. He walked right in the end zone.
Able to waltz right in. Ivan McCartney, his fellow wide receiver, with a nice block to set him free. And now Tyler Bittencourt on for the extra point. Another quick response here by the Mountaineers after a score by Marshall. High snap, and the extra point is good. It was all Tavon Austin on that drive. The guy who is so explosive, 5'9", 170. He goes 0-60 in about 3 seconds. Turns the corner, gets down a 70-yard run, and on the catch, dances right in. 27-10, West Virginia leading. 70-yard run. Eventually, a 6-yard touchdown catch. Didn't take very long, just 41 seconds.
Yeah, it didn't take long at all. His receivers are blocking downfield. Geno Smith is putting the ball proper placement, leading his receivers. Even on the reverse, that pitch was just in the right place where it didn't slow him down. He caught it at full speed and was able to pick up acceleration.
Corey Smith kicking off, a short kickoff this time, taken at the 12-yard line. Time for a game break. Let's go back to Patrick O'Neill. Thanks so much, Patrick. That was a fantastic catch. I'm sure Eddie George has a smile on his face for seeing that one for the Buckeyes. Rakeem Cato Back of the shotgun. On first down, hands it off to Trayvon Van. And Van back the line of scrimmage. Shaq Rowell on the catch, on the tackle, excuse me.
The defensive line for West Virginia really stout in there right now, not giving up much on the run.
This defense, it is a new defense for West Virginia under new defensive coordinator Joe DeForest, who came over from Oklahoma State. Little play action. Cato escapes the pressure, and the pass is juggled and then completed to Gator Hoskins, the tight end. And the fans here, they want to say that it looked like the knee may have been down.
Gator Hoskins, nice focus. Watching that ball and be able to make that reception. Trayvon Van, again, a great block on the blitz coming from the outside.
The 11-yard completion of first down, but this next play is blown dead. It looks like we may have a review first.
The previous play is under further review.
The play that's under review was the catch by Gator Hoskins, the tight end. At first look, this is what you're looking at, was his knee down. The knee was down, but he didn't have possession. When he got possession, he's back up on his feet. So Dana Holgorsen, Doc Holliday await the word on this review. 27-10, West Virginia leading here with 5:37 to go in the first half.
I think they made the right call on the field. Player didn't have possession. Possession came late after he stood up.
And I'd love to give Gator Hoskins all the credit, knowing that his knee was on the ground, so he juggled the ball, then caught it when he was off, but I don't think that was on purpose.
I think he was
trying
to.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. It was a catch.
And when your name is Gator, I don't want to change something on you.
Well, look at the concentration. The ball hits his hands, chest, hands again. He was able to look at the ball right in front of him. Good focus.
So first and 10 here for Marshall. Remy Watson in the backfield. The handoff is to Watson. Tries to cut it back. Gets wrapped up by J.B. Loggeman and Isaiah Bruce. Second and 9. Gave him a pickup of 1 on the play.
Defensive line really coming through here on this drive and making some big stops.
High snap. The handoff once again to Watson. And Watson picks up 2 yards. So 3rd and 7 now coming up here for Marshall. That last drive, they had a big third down conversion. There is the new defensive coordinator for West Virginia, Joe DeForest. Implementing a new scheme here with the Mountaineers. Whenever someone talks about West Virginia, they talk about their offense. He's hoping they'll talk about their defense, too, in a positive way. 3rd and 7. Cato, the pass is complete to Andre Snipes Booker for the first down. This Marshall team now 3 straight drives and moving the ball down the field. For more on this, let's go back to Darius.
Yeah, guys, Marshall is really getting in a groove offensively here, gaining some confidence and definitely gaining some momentum there. Everything they're doing is working so far. Hopefully they can keep this up.
Rakeem Cato quickly back. And the handoff is to Trayvon Van, who's wrapped up in the backfield, a loss of 2.
Cato might have made the wrong read right there. The defensive end that came up and was supposed to take away the ball. If he would have pulled it, he would have been on the outside, in space, opportunity to throw to his receiver or take it for a run.
2nd down and 12 after the loss of 2. Cato, pass over the middle, complete, plenty of room for C.J. Crawford. And Crawford brings it up to the 27-yard line. A 28-yard completion. Pat Miller and Darwin Cook combined for the tackle.
Cato just sitting back there, reading the defense, finding out where the holes are. Made a great throw. Turned out to be a big play.
Play action. Cato over the middle was looking for his tight end Crawford again. The coverage by Darwin Cook. Darwin Cook last year had that 99-yard fumble recovery for a touchdown in the Orange Bowl. He also had 85 tackles last year, which is a top returner for this West Virginia defense. Handoff to Van. Van doesn't have much room, and he'll pick up a couple of yards as Terrence Garvin and Will Clark combine for the stop.
Again, the defensive line, Will Clark, stretching out that play, allowing the linebackers and the safeties to come up and help on run support.
Another third down coming up here for Marshall. Third and nine. Last possession, they kicked a field goal from 35 yards. Cato to the near sideline, incomplete, was looking for Demetrius Evans. All right, so right now you've got the ball at the 26-yard line.
Probably a catchable ball right there. If you just put it right on the inside of him, may have gave him a better chance at it.
You've got 2:46 to go. It would be a 43-yard field goal from right here. Instead, Marshall's going to go for it. On fourth and nine, flag is thrown. Cato escapes and gets rid of it, incomplete to Trayvon Van. But there is a flag on the play.
A lot of pressure there by Tyler Anderson coming up and getting in Cato's face. And
backfield offense. That penalty's declined. First down.
Really created a bad pass.
So now Marshall can't convert on their fourth down. We saw West Virginia earlier unable to convert on their fourth down.
As offenses get faster and quicker and a lot of changes in tempos and a lot of scoring that we're seeing basically trend in college football, you're starting to see more fourth downs being converted or at least going for it.
That wasn't your typical fourth down. That was fourth and nine.
They've got confidence, but then get 9 yards.
Geno Smith joined in the backfield by Ryan Clark and Sean Alston here on first and 10 from the 26. Smith drops back. Looking for somebody open. Tons of time. Now he'll run for it down the sideline. And he'll scoot out of bounds. A 5-yard run there by Geno Smith. A 17-point lead here for the Mountaineers, ranked number 11 in the country.
Smith sitting back there all day. His offensive line doing a nice job of blocking for him. And couldn't find a guy open, so made the smart decision. Just got off the field and gained some yards.
Hand off to Alston. Alston again just lowers that shoulder, and the ball comes loose. And it is recovered by West Virginia.
Right as he was leaning forward, looks like he took a big hit. Jordan Thompson recovering the fumble.
The first down here for the Mountaineers after the fumble recovery. Coming up on 2 minutes to go here in the first half. Smith play action. Take a chance down the field. And it's incomplete, intended for Ivan McCartney. Montarius Lovett on the coverage. It's a nice pass, good coverage by Lovett.
Yeah, great coverage. Didn't let him get past him. Stayed right with him, right in his hip pocket. Just got his arm up in the last second to break up that pass.
Now second down and 10.
A
Bowie in the backfield. Geno Smith, the pass. It's Tavon Austin. Tavon Austin, he's one of those guys where as soon as he gets the ball, he kind of surveys the situation, that stutter step, and it's got to be unnerving if you're a defensive back.
Well, you've seen so many times where he's just all of a sudden, he pushes the pedal and it's full speed. There's really no acceleration point. It's just right away top speed.
On third and one, a handoff to Bowie, has a first down and much more as he brings it up. Brought down at the 43-yard line. Rashawn Myers with his second tackle of the game. A 10-yard run for Bowie and back into this hurry-up offense. No huddle. Smith dumps it off to Bowie out of the backfield, and he'll run out of bounds. 1:26 to go in this first half.
Most teams may have called a timeout there, and all of a sudden they get in this hurry-up offense, get a quick pass to the outside, and are able to stop the clock without burning a timeout.
A 7-yard pickup sets up second down and three. Smith, wide open is Austin. And Austin up to the 21-yard line. Okoroa with the tackle, a 14-yard pickup for the first down.
Mind-boggling why you wouldn't find that player on the field.
It's almost like you have to have a spy on him. Bowie on the handoff. Nice cutback. Bowie, another cutback. Yeah, it's tackled by Okoroa. Another 12-yard run here by Andrew Bowie. With 1:07 to go, this offense is clicking once again.
Derek Mitchell on the missed tackle. They're doing a good job of mixing it up here.
Geno Smith, pump fake, steps up, points at a receiver, and the pass is caught for the touchdown. J.D. Woods got interfered with. It didn't matter. A flag on the play. It will be pass interference.
Pass interference, defense, number two. A penalty declined, touchdown.
A 9-yard touchdown pass to J.D. Woods.
Another accurate pass right there by Geno Smith.
Tyler Bittencourt on for another extra point. To 10. West Virginia now leading with just a minute to go here in this first half. That game on the Pizza Hut Halftime Report. J.D. Woods, a senior from Naples, Florida, the 9-yard touchdown catch. And just when it looked like this Marshall team was gaining confidence, getting back into this game, this West Virginia offense now over 400 total yards. And leading by 24 points. Corey Smith will kick off. Andre Snipes Booker is back deep. Booker about 2 yards deep in the end zone, will bring it out. And he gets tripped up. A flag comes flying in. It looked like the ball may have come loose as well. They're going to say it will stay Marshall ball. Shaq Pettaway on the special teams tackle.
During the return, illegal block in the back. Return team number four, half the distance to the goal, first down.
Demetrius Evans called for the penalty. Let's go back to this touchdown.
Geno Smith, a little pump fake there, but then rolls out, uses his legs, puts an accurate pace on the ball. He's pretty excited about that, isn't he?
No big deal. It's now 34-10. He's having a pretty good first half, I'd say.
I got a feeling they're not done.
Hand off to Remy Watson on first down. And Watson, with that burst of speed, gets up to the 12-yard line, picks up four. Carl Joseph, the freshman free safety, with the tackle.
You think it's going to be a little run or go for the end zone, or do you think they're going to try to get in and get into halftime and make some changes?
Right now, I think you take as much time off the clock and just run, get into the locker room, talk things over, and regroup for the second half if you're Marshall. That should be the final play of this first half. A good first half for the Mountaineers of West Virginia. Geno Smith, 19 for 22, just three incomplete passes, three touchdowns, 190 yards. The Battle of West Virginia in the first half has gone to the Mountaineers. Now let's go back to Patrick O'Neill, Eddie George, and Joey Harrington, who are standing by for the Pizza Halftime Show.